This episode has been shot on the Insta360 X4 and Ace Pro. Stay tuned to find out how you can get a discount on your own Insta360 camera. We are still in Kanchanaburi, Thailand, on an expedition to survey the Boh Yai mine system. A complex operation involving various techniques to document the unexplored. In today's episode on the DiveSAGA channel. In our last episode on the DiveSAGA channel, we started exploring the Boh Yai mine complex with kilometers of tunnels underneath a mountain in the jungle in Thailand. I'm here with a team of exploration divers as they set out to further explore and map these mines past the 106 meter depth mark. And today, we have some mapping to do. In preparation for the dives later this week, where Mikko and Patrick will try to explore depths beyond 100 meters, dozens of bailout cylinders will need to be prepared. And we are in need of some extra oxygen, but the Thai countryside isn't exactly sprawling with dive shops. Luckily, we do find what we need and are able to buy a few cylinders at a local gas supplier. It goes to show that planning remote expeditions like this is not an easy task. Under the watchful eye of Tiger the base camp dog, Mikko sets up his photogrammetry equipment.
I've received a lot of questions about how they make maps for these types of environments. So luckily I'm here with Patrick Widmann and Mikko Paasi, prominent cave divers and mine divers. So I figured I would pick their brain on what techniques they actually use to survey and map these types of environments.
Time to head back in the water. But this time, two teams will be mapping and surveying the mine, and both teams will be using different techniques. Mikko will be using a setup that he conceived himself, mostly aimed at collecting 360-degree footage of the environment in real time to construct a three-dimensional model of the mine that can even be used with virtual reality. Patrick and his team use a different technique. Their data collection revolves around measuring the installed lines and collecting accurate data about their GPS coordinates, direction, length, and depth that can be added to existing maps.
We are using a surveying tool called the mNemo. We're using the version 2 of it. And this basically works together with a surveying software, which is called Ariane's Line. So basically we collect the data with this little device here. And then once we come back to Basecamp, we upload it onto the laptop into the software. And then we can see the entire map. We can even overlay it on Google Earth, so you see the starting point, and then you can see the surrounding area with all of the lines that we have laid underneath it.
If you're a viewer of the DiveSAGA channel or a cave diver, then you probably already know this, but it's important to understand that when cave and mine divers first explore an area, they install a line into the system. This line serves as a way to find the exit, even in case of a loss of visibility. But the line can also be used as the core of the surveying operation with the mNemo.
So once we're at the station, there's an arrow here. We clip the device to the line like this. Once it is stabilized, it has measured the depth and it has measured the compass heading. Once this is done, it says go, and now we're basically going down the line. As we are going down, it actually measures the distance of the line that we're traveling down. Right, it measures again the depth and it measures the compass heading, and it will now do the math of the actual distance. Right, because you can imagine if we would have 7 meters of line, but it's very inclined, if you would look at it from bird view, the line would actually be shorter. I clip it to the other side of the station, Okay, it says go, and I'm measuring this part. So once we collected the data, we put it into the program, this all goes automatic, and then you can see here the map, and the map has an insane amount of detail, right? You have the starting point, you can put in all of the depth of each one of the stations, all of the comments, like where do we want to keep on going, where does the cave go, where it doesn't go. There's like an insane amount of information that helps us to be more efficient in our exploration.
While the data collected with the mNemo provides hard measurements that are extremely useful in exploration, Mikko's approach is to collect visual data for analysis afterwards.
Throughout the years, I started to develop a little bit easier system that could actually be used also when you're kind of like exploring the mine or the cave the first time. So you would have your hands-free system kind of that constantly the settings are correct. The biggest issue was always the lights, that you have to have even lights from 360. So you could actually film with the 360 camera as well. Like I do two big blue 36,000 lumen video lights with diffusers. The diffusers are the key because then it diffuses the light all over evenly. And I use these remote controls. Makes my life easier when I'm changing the environment. If I come from, let's say, from a chamber to a restriction, and I'm mapping, I'm going by foot or by scooter, then I need to change the light power because the walls are getting more closer. And with the remote control, it's easy. I can now control the light power from my shoulder instead of stopping with the scooter or stopping swimming. So just control it from here.
This is probably the best time to tell you about the Insta360 X4, exactly the type of camera that Mikko is using for this project. Because the Insta360 X4 actually has two lenses which each shoot at 180 degree field of view and then stitches that together to get a 360 degree image, which you can then manipulate afterwards to frame your shot the way you want it. It's an incredibly powerful camera, but Insta360 also makes the Ace Pro. All of our episodes are shot almost entirely on the Insta360 Ace Pro. So I've put a link below where you can pick up one of these or both at a discount. I want to also explicitly thank Insta360 for supporting this series on the DiveSAGA channel.
The vehicle, any scooter, very simple, selfie stick, so super annoying, but very handy because you can actually attach it to your scooter, and then you got the 360 camera over there, pointed straight outwards, so it films up, down, everywhere, and you don't even see the stick.
It's quite a contraption, but this way, by using the time-lapse feature on the Insta360 X4, Mikko is able to collect thousands upon thousands of data points. This view only shows him, but remember that every photo the X4 takes is actually a spherical image with a 360-degree view of the mine. Because there are kilometers of mine to be mapped, this approach may not provide precise distance measurement, but does eventually produce a 3D model that can later be analyzed to spot missed passages. Meanwhile, Patrick's team provides the exact coordinates. There are two very different approaches with different use cases, but it's super cool to see them both in action at the same time. Underwater technology has come a long way, and mapping tools and techniques like these may eventually be used to produce databases of underwater environments that can be very useful to study aquifers or organize rescue operations. Although it's not the focal point of this series, it's worth mentioning that Mikko Paasi is one of the cave divers who assisted in the Thai cave rescue of 2018. When 12 boys and their football coach were trapped in a flooded cave. Back then, data like this was non-existent, but it does highlight one of the many use cases of underwater mapping. Once the mapping of the known line is done, it is time for the team to go all in and push the existing lines into unexplored territory. But that will be for our next episode.
That's it for today here on the DiveSAGA channel. As always, if you want to support the channel, just remember, subscribe, like, maybe send to your friends, pick up some merch while you're at it. I really appreciate you guys watching and your enthusiasm, and I will see you next time.